Today we'll be taking a look at this creative e-design in Adobe Illustrator. And without wasting much time, let's go to our rectangle tool and let's try and disable the stroke we have. Then I'm going to change the color to something like off-white. Then I'll click OK. Then I'm going to click where it says intersect. I'm going to click and drag and drop where it says intersect. Then I'm going to lock that layer. Then I'll create another layer just above it. Then I'm going to change my shape to ellipse too. I'll try and disable the fill. And I'm going to change the stroke color to about deep. Let me use this deep gray. Click OK. Then I'm going to click and drag while holding Alt and Shift to create this perfect ellipse or circle. Then I'm going to change the stroke width to 55. Then I'm going to Object. Then I'm going to Expand. I'll make sure Fill and Stroke is checked. I'll click OK. Just to create fill and stroke around the object. Then I'm going to reduce the size, still holding Alt and Shift. Then I'm going to move it in place, just like that. So next, I'm going to select my pen tool. I'm going to click right above that point close to the center, but not necessarily the center. Then I'm going to click and try and make this curve. Then I'm going to press Alt on my keyboard and click on that last anchor point to end the curve there. I'm going to click on that path and I'm going to click and drag. I'm going to click on Alt on my keyboard and click on that last anchor point and close up the path. So I'll hold Ctrl while I adjust the angles of the path that we just created. I'll select the anchor point while holding Alt on my keyboard, and I'm going to drag the handles just to adjust the curves. Then all good. I'm going to drag and select on every shape. I'm going to select my shape builder to holding Alt on my keyboard. I'm going to click to remove that part. As you can see, this is the first phase of this design. So the next thing, I'm going to select that shape and I'm going to hold Alt to make a duplicate while holding Shift to keep it on that straight line. Then I'm going to right click and then I'm going to transform. Then I'm going to reflect vertical at first. I'll click OK. Then I'm going to repeat the same thing, but this time around I'll be flipping on the horizontal axis. Now click OK. I'm going to select my pen tool. Then I'm going to click on that last anchor point there. I'll click. Then I'm going to move my mouse right about that position. I'll click and drag just to make that curve. And I'm going to press Alt on my keyboard and click on the last anchor point to end the curve. Right about that point again, I'm going to click and drag, making sure I'm clicking on the path of the shape. So I'm going to hold Alt and click on the last anchor point there and close up the path. Then I'm going to hold Ctrl on my keyboard and click on the last anchor point there. Then I'll click and drag to adjust the handles. I'll do the same thing for this anchor point too. Holding my Ctrl, then I'm going to adjust the path and make it smooth as possible. Then I'm going to do the same thing over there. Going to do for the last anchor point too. So can you just take your time and make the curve smooth and perfect as you want. So I'm taking my time just to adjust the handles of the curves to have more perfect curve. So I'll make sure the path is coming down towards, just to reduce the thickness of the shape. So as you can see, everything is all looking good. So the next I'm going to do is I'm going to cut off that part. So we are still going to use the same technique. So I'm going to click right about that point. click right about the point, then I'll try and close up the shape. So I'm going to select my selection tool. I'll drag and select over the two shapes. Then I'm going to select my shape builder tool. Holding Alt on my keyboard, I'm going to minus all those selections. As you can see, we've successfully cut off that part. So the next thing I'm going to do now is I'm going to make another part just in between this, our last object, towards the top. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'll create that part right about that point. So let me change the color of this our object first. So I'm going to change the color right about that color, be using that color. So for the other object, which is this, I'll be using a darker shade of it, but I'm going to send to the back first, as I've done. Then I'm going to select it and I'm going to press I for the eyedropper. Then I'm going to double click on it. I'm going to bring it down just to select the darker shade of the color. So I'm going to click OK. As you can see, all looking good. So the next thing I'm going to do now is, as I've said earlier, we're going to try and cut off this part. So I'm going to select my pen, so just press P on my keyboard. I'll click on that anchor point. I'll click on that part right above that point. Click and drag. I try and make a simple gentle curve. And I'm going to click on that point also. Right above that thickness is okay. I'll do the same thing on the lower part too. I'll try and calculate for the thickness and I'll click. And I'm going to bend it a bit to create a curve. I'm going to click to close that part. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the last anchor point there. While holding Control, I'll try and adjust the curve. I'll do the same thing also for this other part. I'll try and adjust the curve. So I'm going to do this and make sure the curve is perfect, but making sure you press down Control on your keyboard while adjusting those anchor points. So I'm going to select and drag over everything. I'll select my shape builder tool. I'm going to hold Alt on my keyboard while I click and drag just to slice out that particular portion. So that's the result of the whole thing we've been doing. So the next thing I'm going to do now is I'm going to try and create like a shadow just below this object we have on top. So I'll select my pen tool and I'm going to click right about the anchor point. I'll click at that anchor point. Then I'm going to click at this last anchor point. Then I'm going to click and drag and make that curve. Then I'm going to hold Alt on my keyboard just to end the curve there. Then I'm going to try and close up the path. I'll try and close up the path just like that. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the color. I'm going to change the color, double click, and I'm going to change the color to something a little bit darker, but not as dark as the one we have below it. So I'm going to select it and go to my layers, and I'm going to bring it, that's the part we have on top there. So I'm going to click and bring it just below that group. So the next thing we're going to do now is, as you can see, we need to adjust our logo because it's already looking nice. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust, make a few adjustments. Then I'm going to click and drag over everything at first. Then I'm going to try and reduce the size. I'm going to reduce it just about that size is good. So I'm trying to make a few adjustments to the design just to make it pop out the more. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to click and drag and just select the upper part of this our design. I'm going to click and drag and select on the upper part of this our design, just this upper part. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate it. Then I'm going to And I'm going to use my arrow keys just to move it in position. I'm using my arrow keys just for accuracy and just to try and match up things equally. So while using my arrow keys, I'll try and match the object up. So I'm going to click and drag over everything. Then I'm going to do the final rotation. Then I'm going to rotate just like that. Boom! As you can see, our creative e-design is not looking all good. So what we're going to do next is I'm going to select and drag over everything. I'm going to try and reduce the size. Then I'll move it up just like that. So I'm going to select my type 2. Then I'm going to change the color first. Let me just type out. So I'm going to type evolution. Then I'm going to hold my alt and shift and make the text a little bit bigger, just like that. So I'm going to use my eyedropper tool to sample the color from the edge by just pressing I on my keyboard. Then I'll move the text in position. Click and drag over everything and adjust the overall position. So as you can see, using the paint tool and the shape builder tool, we're able to manipulate this our e-design. So if you really enjoyed this tutorial, please make sure you like this video, subscribe and hit the notification icon so you'll be the first to be notified when next I drop another content like this. Thank you for your time, till meet next time.